How the Grinch Stole Civil Liberties. Anyway, we've got a great show tonight. Take it away, gang.
And that's all the military-grade weaponry. And here we have the old precinct. Look sharp, you bozos. This is our new police chief, Amanda Pickleson. Chief Pickleson, I'd like you to meet our finest detective, Sabrina Goodwin, and her decidedly average partner, Samuel Kitts.
Pleasure, Chief. Nice to finally have another bird in the coop.
Never seen a Dane put in charge before. Think you can handle it, baby?
I'll try. Given that this is one of the better practical jokes I've been a victim of, I'm gonna let that one slide. So, what are your real names?
How rude of us! You still don't know everyone's names! This old claptrap is Hildy McTilly. She's the best tip line operator on this side of Mississippi.
Oh, too slow, lollipop.
What is happening?
Murder! What?
The fuzz told you?
All of my old boss told me was that a chief position opened up in Maltese, Connecticut, and that I'd be dealing with some pretty old and crazy cases. Oh. I know we're not the cream of the crop, big timer, but sometimes you gotta make time for the small time, you dig? maybe. Let's just get to work. What is our first case? Murder! Oh, you were serious.
Well,
not much can surprise me at this point.
It was our last police chief.
Never mind.
He was murdered.
Yeah, I got that. Do you have any information?
Nope. Oh, we got a witness, though. He was apprehended just moments after the old boss had gone cold.
All right. Where is he?
The interrogation room.
Okay. All I see is his old broom closet.
Same thing.
Well, I hope he hasn't been waiting long.
Only since the crime was committed.
Yeah, 3 days ain't bad.
We are very sorry, ma'am. If you could just follow me this way, we can begin the interrogation.
Oh, that's just our janitor, Marla Backside. She lives in there.
And you must be...
That's Patty, her assistant.
She doesn't speak.
Well, then... Where the fuck is the witness?
Water!
It's too dusty in here!
That's water stat. We are very sorry, sir. I know you must be exhausted, but if you could just go this way, we can begin the interrogation. Hank tells me you're the last person to see the old chief alive.
Well, that's right.
Would you mind telling me what you remember from that day? Be anything at all. Noises, smells, anything unusual.
Well, now that you mention it, I did have an unusually noisy and smelly bowel.
About the murder, I mean.
Well, I'm getting there, Toots. Anyway. I was just beginning to wipe the old tuchus when I heard a sound like a cough.
What do you think it was?
It was a cough. A man's cough. And then a thud, like a man's body hitting the floor.
What was it?
It was a man's body hitting the floor.
So that's when you discovered the old chief?
What? No! That's when I discovered Mr. McMahon.
Well, who in the hell is Mr. McMahon?
He was the town mailman, handyman, and man of the year, 3 times running.
I was coming in to report his murder when I found the chief lying on the desk with a knife in his butt.
I'm sorry, what?
Knife! In his butt!
So, there have been not one, but 2 murders in this town in the past week, and only 1 witness to see any of it.
Bingo!
Winner, winner, chicken dinner.
Mine was better.
Well, we've never really had any murders here before, or crimes, actually.
Hildy has been on the tip line this whole time.
That old canary sings all day.
But at least she can carry a tune.
Hildy's on the phone with her mother. Tell the old lady we say a big hello.
Precinct says hi, Mar.
Hello, everybody.
You look like you're not afraid of the back door.
My wife
got married and divorced, young.
The old woman got married and divorced. Oh.
Who else in this town might you want to interrogate?
It's cute, boss. Real cute.
Very inappropriate conduct, Sabrina. That is going on your record.
Like you could ever replace me, sweet cheeks.
That's awfully confident for someone with 2 strikes on her record. But cheeks.
She's still not getting it.
There is no one else.
We're it, Chief.
My boss said this town was small, but not 7 people.
Well, it was 9 last week.
Now I'm getting plucked off 1 by gosh darn 1!
Which means one of us is a murderer! That surprised you.
Oh, this is so exciting! A real murderer in our police station!
Murder? In this economy?
Jesus. She still thinks it's the Great Depression.
Talk about a cat who never left the alley of the past.
I can't fuck FDR.
Can we please focus? There is a murderer amongst us.
Murder? I hardly know her.
I think the only fair solution is for all of us to interrogate everyone here. Hank, you'll lead the questioning.
Excellent! How?
Hildy, we'll start with you.
Oh, lollipop.
I don't understand the question.
I got it. Where were you the morning of Friday, April the 13th?
I understand the question now.
I was here at the precinct on the horn with my mother.
Likely alibi.
Seems a little too convenient.
No, I meant it's probably true. I saw her here.
You were in the office.
Yeah, I came in to talk to Sabrina.
And you were here.
Yes!
Okay, show of hands. Who was in the office that day?
Strange sensual dreams about it myself. That doesn't mean a thing. It's always been you. It's always been you, Sabrina.
Okay, but like, why did you kill the chief?
Because
he discovered my secret. I was about to have an affair with the chief. And I would have gotten away with it too if it weren't for you meddling kids. What?
Woo!
Our next scene is the Italian shark mafia. The scene combines Italy, wildlife, and incomprehensible language. It's like my ex-girlfriend's Instagram come to life. Apparently, the study of broad Wi-Fi in the apartment housing in Florence is good enough to post pictures with fucking Kevin, but I can't even get a text back. I guess some mysteries are better left unsolved.
Just had another shark incident. That makes the third one this week. I don't know why these people keep going down the ocean, but they just do. The male ones keep this on the down low, so it's not back tourism, so I called you here.
Well, I am the best shark research scientist in this part of the state, especially after what happened to Steve. May he rest in peace.
My condolences on Steve's retirement. He was quite a shark a long time ago. 50 years on the job really took a toll on him. He looks like he got chewed on by a shark and spat back out again. Anyways, I called you here to help with our town shark club. Now talk about Steve.
Right. I believe that we should begin with 5 years.
5 years? Are you crazy? At this rate, the entire town will be wiped out in 5 years.
Well, what do you want me to do? There's only one other option. But it's never been tested before.
Come on, we don't have enough time for that.
There's only one way I do my work. And that is... dramatically!
Just tell me your option, would you?
Right. We could call in a shark whisperer.
Are you kidding me?
Jerry, get in here!
So you're a shark whisperer?
I don't know. Is there money involved?
Well, there's a $10,000 reward for anyone who can kill the shark that's been terrorizing our tourists, so...
Well, sure. Jerry the Shark Whisperer at your service.
You tell me this kid can talk to sharks?
Oh, I can totally talk to sharks. I was raised by sharks. Well, I was raised in Oklahoma City by a Baptist parents, but same thing.
Oklahoma City is even by the ocean.
The ocean is in your heart.
I totally agree with that. Listen, Jerry here's the real deal. He helped me communicate with Goldie in the afterlife.
Yeah, I did. He said...
That's exactly what it used to sound like! I admit it!
Wait, did Goldie a goldfish?
It was so pure!
And I don't even know if it's a dead shark, I need to kill a live one.
Oh, man. Yeah, man, I got you. I can do both. Plus, if I kill 6 sharks for you, the 7th one's on me.
This is ridiculous. There is absolutely no way.
We would have such deep conversations. He'd go, and I'd go,
right? We just had another incident at the harbor. Since I have no other choice, you're hired. I need you to infiltrate the local gang of sharks and kill whichever one's been terrorizing our town. Got it?
Great. I still have my shark disguise.
Great. I'm sure you fit right in.
And if you need us, we'll be at the beach. Working. Obviously, working.
Arthur!
I told you, Marco, I want Angela for lunch. We just had Mexican yesterday.
I told you, Antonio, Swedish food gives me gas.
All right, what about Bob? Just good, old-fashioned American food.
Silencio!
Don Giovanni says he wants Middle Eastern food.
Silencio, stupido!
Sorry, he says Shelby Bimbo mediates.
A chi è quello?
He asks, how's the weather today?
Chi è quello, stupido?
Sorry, he asks, who's that?
Oh, sorry, is this not the Hammy Island Scuba Club meeting? You know, I probably read the memo wrong. I'm gonna go, actually. So,
we have known each other many years. But this is the first time you have come to my house for a cup of coffee. It is the first time you have come to me for counsel or for help. Ah, but I cannot remember the last time you invited me to your house for a cup of coffee. To know my wife is godmother to your only child.
But let's be frank here.
You never wanted my friendship. And you feared it to be in my dad.
Oh, I understand. You found paradise in America. You had trade, you made a good living. The police protected you, and there were courts of law. So you didn't need a friend like me. And now you come to me and you say, Don Corleone, give me justice. but you don't ask with respect. You don't offer friendship. You don't even think to call me godfather.
I'm sorry, I've never met this man in my life.
I'm sorry, but honestly the only thing you can say to
me. Silencio! Get
Are you the new security shot?
Security? Yes! Mamma mia! I was in Little Italy getting my pizza and the breadsticks. Oh, when I saw the end, thought, Mamma mia!
We need to stop getting our security shark from Roberto. You know he picks them up around the nuclear treatment plant, and they always turn out a little weird. Remember the last guy took a bite out of the donut shaped inner tube and died? How we get. Just look at him. What do you think he's doing with that guy?
Come ti chiami?
He asks, are you single?
Come ti chiami, stupido?
Excuse me. He asks what your name is.
My name? My name is, Little Mario. Mamma mia. That's what all the kids call me, back in little Italy. They say I can make a sick panini.
Anyways, Little Mario, if you can just stand next to Don Shark Giovanni and protect him from the rival mob.
I didn't realize Don was here. Oh, we were best buds in high school. You know, I thought you'd be a lawyer in Sacramento with a few kids by now.
Hey, Don isn't the head of the mob.
Oh, I didn't realize. Your Majesty.
Little Mario, if you can just stand here and make sure you don't see any suspicious seafood.
Who is your rival mob, exactly?
Our enemies swim with the fishes.
Of course they swim with the fishes. That's their business, damn it.
We have two enemies, too. We have our old enemies, the Hammerheads, then there's our business rival, the Starkist family.
The canned tuna people?
Il loro nome non deve essere menzionato in questa casa.
Don, he says you retire soon.
Il loro nome non deve essere menzionato in questa casa, stupido!
He says to say Starkist is awesome.
Ah, stupido!
Do you guys think you can tell this guy to stop hitting me?
You're the interpreter. I don't speak Italian.
I can't even do the accent.
I'm no Indonesian. I tried to.
Stupido!
Anyways, yes, the tuna people. They are trying to take over our legal enterprise.
What do? Do you sell coke? Molly. Roofies. Moonshine? Mamma mia.
We illegally can tuna, you fool.
Stupido!
Ow! That wasn't even me, it was him!
Stupido!
Ow! So you're all the mob that illegally sells tuna?
Yes, we are on a mob that illegally sells canned tuna. The black market tuna sales are very cutthroat. If you have control over the canned tuna black market, you practically have control over North Korea.
And don't forget about the other familia. They started an all-out war against us. Just last week they sliced open the belly of Giovanni's brother. Ever since then we've been seeking a vengeance against the strange crime family known only as the police.
So, I hear that the police enjoy donuts.
Like those things the last guy ate and died from?
No, don't you like the-
Silencio, stupido!
What if we throw them a donut party?
So that what?
He says
you'd
like you to go. We'll get some watermelon from the
store. So that stupido!
Okay, one more time and I quit.
You can't quit. We never hired you. We just kidnapped you.
Anyways, can you make donuts underwater? We need to infiltrate the police and kill them from the inside.
Silencio, stupido!
Wait, that's not actually a bad idea, but we need someone who can fit in with this obscure family. And we can pay them, $3,000.
I am a master of disguise.
Mi fido di lui.
Really? You trust him and not me?
Silencio, stupido!
I will be there shortly. You have good heat.
Mamma mia! You won't believe this! There's an Italian shark bomb who's out to kill all of us! They run an underground tuna ring and have control over North Korea!
Why are you talking in that terrible Italian accent?
Sorry.
Also, you must think I'm stupid. I knew you couldn't talk to sharks, but I didn't think you'd come up with some sort of ridiculous story to cover it up.
No.
This is just like that time I had with that man saw that serial dog kidnapping case who said to talk to the moon.
No, I'm not kidding! They're gonna come here!
I'll give you $5,000 to leave me alone.
Well, you insist.
I think I'm gonna go for a swim.
It's time to implement the next part of our plan.
I agree.
When did Finding Dory get minor?
City. One miniature, riding a heater, Tom Collins in hand, shotting up some vaguely ethnic broads by the blackjack table. The next, some rooski has got you hanging over the boardwalk by your ankles, trying to get his grubby paws on your last empanada. Anyway, this next scene is Miss Timothy Green, with the look at a lot of you guys' favorite reality dating show. You certainly don't want to miss Timothy Green.
No, it's too difficult.
Steve, get a hold of yourself!
We can do this!
That's the right attitude, Kayla. We just need more time.
Good morning, officers.
Oh, look. It's the dog.
Brett! How's the assignment?
Oh, it's just fine, dork. But we're stuck on a puzzle.
What seems to be the issue?
There's been a threat to the cast and crew of that reality TV show, The Single Man.
The what one?
The Single Man. You've never watched?
26 gorgeous young women dress up and compete, all to win the heart of one totally beautiful single stud. All to become Miss Timothy Green.
With all due respect, that show sounds like a piece of crap, sir.
Perhaps, dork, perhaps. But
we were tech pieces of crap.
At least the ones in this country!
Yeah, dork.
God, Kayla, shut your hedgehog of a mouth!
Sorry, boss.
Someone has threatened to fill the show's set with a swarm of Australian gerbils. Do you know what those gerbils can do, agents? Bite people! So in order to protect these bimbos from a gerbil apocalypse, we need a spy from within the agency to protect them.
Sir, I volunteer.
No! We need a hot lady. A hot lady to blend in with the other hot ladies. To compete. Hot lady to hot lady.
I wish I was a hot lady.
Yes, Steve. No! We need a total super babe. Not some nerdy, dorky, Dorkerstein like yourself!
Damn it, you're right!
Drawing a blank. No one here is hot enough.
Boss!
What is it? Oh my God!
What is it?
But that's impossible! You never brush your hair! You fart in public! I've never even seen you eat a salad before!
Wait. Take the glasses off.
Okay, okay, all right! It is just as I suspected! She's a secret hottie! We all know what that means. We found our spy!
Oh, no! Absolutely not!
Oh, but Verena, secret hottie!
Steve, please! I've known many secret hotties in my day. What we are looking for here are professional actresses, bimbos, and, pardon my French, salutes! Samuel, I'd love to help you, I would! But we have already cast this season, and we have a hot lady for every role. The crier, the villain, the virgin, the person of color, the lizard face, the what?
Wait, for real! You've had the crazies, and you've had the floozies. But I'll bet you there's one type of girl you've never had on this show before.
Try me.
Ironic. Quirky. Relatable. Girl!
I'm listening.
She likes pina coladas. And getting caught in the rain. She listens to the same sad music you do, but she would rather go and get a beer with the guys than go out dancing. Put simply, she's not like other girls.
Daniel, it's genius! She'll exit the limo wearing Converse sneakers.
I won't let you down, sir.
Better not, dork. Now just remember, the attacker said they'd hit when the clock strikes 11:59. And that gerbil mania could be anyone among these ladies here. So keep your eyes open! We'll be in the bushes. Listening for squeaks.
Hi, sweetie, what's your name?
Sam.
Stacy, I'm not wearing any underwear.
Oh!
gonna like me.
I think your chances are good. Now, Stacey, how did you prepare for
this? What's up, Sugar Love?
Hello! I'm Sam.
Tammy. What a party, right?
Right. I'm sorry, I don't mean to be rude, but are you...
Prego?
Yeah.
I got two bums in my oven. Being a single mom's hard. That's why I need a man in my life.
Right. Now, Tammy, have you heard any word about gerbils around the house? Maybe seen any rodent feces?
No, nothing like that. But there's crab cakes over there, and she's buzzing.
Wine coolers. Don't mind if I do.
Maybe you shouldn't.
Oh, we go.
I'm gonna take a cheese ball, thanks.
Oh. Also, I think somebody roofied her drink because she's not moving too good.
What?
Oh, no. I just gave her some NyQuil. She'll be out in a jiff.
That's still not okay.
And you are?
Sam.
Ooh, quirky girl.
I guess. Oh. And now, Selene, have you talked to any of the other women about owning gerbils, maybe as pets?
Oh, honey, I'm not here to make friends. I'm here to get my man and lots and lots of airtime.
Oh, so you're the villain.
I don't appreciate that term. I prefer misunderstood.
Okay, our little ironic princess, let's get you in front of a camera.
Camera?
What about me?
You know more about those rodents. points than you let on, Prince Charming.
I'm sure I don't know what you're talking about.
Come on!
No, Toad! Not the shoes!
What's going on here, Green?
All right. It's too late now, anyway. They said there were no pets allowed in the trailer, but I had to bring my two best friends, my gerbils, Tommy and Ron. But it turns out Ron was actually Roberta.
Gerbil poxers.
They reproduced like gerbils. I was trapped in there, doomed to be the single man forever. It was my only hope. Sick the savages on the cast and crew and get my revenge.
Where are those little fluff balls, you beautifully chiseled stud?
Hitting them everywhere within a 5-mile radius. They're sedated now, but once they awaken at 11:59, you're all done for.
Not so fast.
Oh, honey, no.
Sir, thousands of gerbils have congregated around the box of food I left on his bait. We've secured the area and the little guys are safe and sound.
No! You all pay for the imprisonment I've endured. They're psychotic, I tell you.
Looks like you'll be going away for a long time, you gloriously handsome hunk. Well, not too shabby for a little Dorkerstein like yourself.
Thanks. Could I maybe have a new nickname?
Not a chance. But, you want these plastic pilot wings? My nephew got them on our last flight with Delta.
Sure. Thanks.
Anytime, young grasshopper. Anytime.
On this week. Oh my god! The next scene is Kill Your Darlings Faster. See, the thing about Corinne is she's beautiful, she loves Nick, everybody, she's just misunderstood. See, okay, this is Skylar Tarnas's final scene written with EOS Senior. He's written a bunch of pieces for us. We're blessed to have him. He's incredible. See, Corinne is a Machiavellian genius, and nobody appreciates her. She's a sex-positive young girl trying to make it in a cold world. So, she's gonna make it to The Bachelor. Fuck the haters. All right.
Not address you with a more lengthy salutation. Hello, for instance, or hi, top of the morning, or oh my god, long time no see, or bonjour, or good afternoon, or or
I told you to stay away from me, you monster, you animal, I trusted you!
But first, friends, Romans, countrymen, listeners, readers, watchers, eaters, prayers, lovers. Welcome to my TED Talk. I'm very grateful to the organizers for having me back and have assured them that this time I will keep control of myself. But enough about that. Let's check in on this dramatic scene.
Oh yes, Sophie! They'll pay for this!
Bankrupt! Bankrupt!
I don't get it. iPad. I'm a millennial.
Listen up, creators of tomorrow, and we're going to teach you to deal with the millennial attention span.
Attention problems aren't confined to millennials.
Well, it's happened, folks. The world has changed, and our old standards just aren't suitable for this generation of instant gratification. Once, we read tomes of War and Peace and watched films with epic love stories that romanticized the antebellum South. But now, we tweet and Tumblr and Vine. Well, apparently not that last one anymore.
Oh God, R.I.P.
So buckle up! Because you may win Oscars and Tonys and other guy names, but you never really make it in the creative business if you don't adapt to changing mindsets. Now, Mr. Millennial, what was your problem with the scene we just saw played?
Well, the lack of buildup was an issue and the writing wasn't exactly. Oh yeah, also, too long.
Too long! Woe betide you if you make your audience's mind wander. If you want an effect, you've got to pack your enormously complex content into a teeny tiny space. Like trying to fit your non-high school body into your high school jeans.
I told you they look fine.
Don't flatter me, Angus. But the point is, we live in a busy age. We've got to go, 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 and we don't have the time to invest our emotions in anything or anyone. But let's take a look at some of our literature. This stuff titillated past generations. But how about now? What was the last book you read?
Books? What's that, Vic?
So let's teach some old dogs new tricks with my simple tips. Please welcome Herman Melville, author of Moby Dick, and J.K. Rowling, author of the Harry Potter series.
Yes, I'm apparently J.K. Rowling.
And I'm Herman Melville, not dead for 200 years or anything.
Have you thought through this at all?
No, look at these massive books. Who has the time? You don't.
People have been reading Moby Dick for generations.
No, they've been saying they read it and then bullshitting book reports for their teachers, who also never read it.
I never read it.
I just didn't think it was very good.
My tale of Ishmael, Ahab, and the white whale, and the uncomfortable depictions of non-European cultures has fascinated the literature.
Yet just in the summary, there was too much going on. Here. This can go, this can go, let me see. Oh, this can definitely go. Literally, all of this can go. Doesn't this feel good?
No!
But you know what, Herman? A picture is worth 1,000 words. So, if you just got rid of all this unnecessary text and just drew a little picture of a whale inside.
But Moby Dick represents the unknowability.
Okay, buddy, a big picture of a whale. We'd get it. We'd all get it. It'll save us hours. Now to come to you, Rowling. Harry Potter. God, just by the end of the title I'm bored.
Okay, but millennials, like, actually read Harry Potter? Like, specifically? Like, that's a thing that we love? Why isn't it on a screen? I'm confused.
Let's make this simple, JK. Kudos for already abbreviating your name.
It's pronounced JK.
Look, I hear good things, but if you want to make it in this business, you've got to cut out all the grossy middle stuff. Now, what's your first sentence?
Mr. and Mrs. Dursley of number...
That's enough. Cool, cool. And your last sentence?
Like, the very, very, very last? All was well.
Spoilers.
It's been 10 years.
It's been 10 years!
Fantastic! That's all you need. First and last sentence. In fact, just cut out that first one too. All was well. I'd read that book. And get out. I mean, really, can't all literature, classic or not, be boiled down to a few simple themes? Jane Eyre.
Life sucks for women.
The Scarlet Letter.
Life sucks for women.
The Awakening.
Life sucks for women.
Of Mice and Men.
Life sucks for the disabled. And also women.
Oliver Twist.
Life sucks for the poor.
The Great Gatsby.
Life sucks for the rich.
Enter the ride.
Life sucks!
Dracula!
I'm a bloodthirsty vampire that is compelled to kill you.
Ah! Twilight!
I'm a bloodthirsty vampire who's compelled to kill you.
Fifty Shades of Grey.
Now I am an abusive billionaire who's compelled to beat you.
Is this literally Twilight fanfiction?
Anyways!
Yes, yeah, so much for literature. We all know it's going to be dead in a year anyways.
Book sales are actually going back
up. Now. Bill! That's where it's at. Who doesn't remember this emotional scene from The Notebook?
If you're a bird, I'm a bird.
But wow, that took forever.
If you're a bird, I'm a bird.
Faster!
If you bird, I bird.
Faster!
We bird.
Faster! Faster! Much better. Now, don't you really feel the love these two have for each other? Filmmakers, if you follow my simple tips, you can trim the fat from your creations for a better, simpler product. Now, don't you really know that all Disney movies can basically be combined? Snow White!
Nope, I got no parents.
Cinderella!
Nope, I got no parents.
Sleeping Beauty!
I basically got no parents.
Rapunzel!
Basically got no parents.
Belle!
I've only got a father!
Ariel!
A father and a tail! Parents! After a certain time, right?
But really, with films, you're just there for those classic movie moments.
Dinosaur!
A shark! Shark! Alien!
Predator!
Bird!
Godzilla!
And the real villain,
Man!
There's your movie. That's all you need.
But isn't there something missing? Like depth or emotional connection or keeping up with the Kardashians? Ooh! Jersey Shore, woo! The Bachelor, The Bachelorette, The Bachelorelike, Gilmore Girls.
And then there's the stage. Well, by the time you've walked to the theater and sat down, that's already too much time. So let's try not to get swept away in how fancy or metaphorical we are. You know how much time we'd save if Death of a Salesman started with The Death of a Salesman? Or if Waiting for Godot started with Godot.
Sorry, I'm late, guys.
Or if The Crucible, I don't know, started with a crucible.
Line. A crucible, situation of severe trial.
Oh. Or how about Shakespeare, the sinister wordsmith who's tormented students and actors for hundreds of years? But how simple are his plots, really? Romeo and Juliet.
Oh. Oh, no!
Macbeth.
No!
A Midsummer Night's Dream. And then we come to the Broadway musical. Lin-Manuel Miranda can't save you all. In the writing biz, they tell you to kill your darlings. I say, kill them faster. Les Miserables! Sweeney Todd! Cats!
Memories!
I'm not doing that one.
No, sorry.
Fair. But why have all these separate elaborate, confusing plots anyways.
No.
Tomorrow,
my God.
We won't care, and tomorrow, there is no day but today.
Why do you call it your old fashioned?
He's there, the fiddler on the roof. Beware, the metaphor on the roof.
No room for subtlety, pack it in!
He had it coming. Hamilton had himself to blame.
If it's not in 140 characters, it's not worth saying!
Little state of Oklahoma, little state, really problematic.
Art is dead!
Because of the curse, they went into the woods.
Stop! For the love of God, stop!
No.
Don't have to do this, Hortensia!
I do. I wish it wasn't this way, but it is. Nobody cares about anything but sound bites anymore.
But look at it this way. You've been talking for a really long time. Definitely over long time. And you went on a lot of tangents and probably could have made your point in the first minute. And they're all still here. I think someone probably left.
Are still here, aren't they?
It's not so bad, hon. You see, Michael Bay movies, apparently, yeah, but it's not hard for all films of art as long as we keep evolving and don't, you know, belittle our audience like you keep doing.
Angus?
There's hope for us yet.
Oh, Angus, I anyways, drive home safe, and you can find more talks on our YouTube channel. Go ahead and like us on Facebook. If you don't mind, follow us on @YoungTwitter @RC_play.